I designed my own custom labels to slap them on the virtual 3D cam just so I can make stream alerts for you. So those can be used by both Twitch and YouTube streamers. There's a total of 10. And in this video, I'm gonna show you how to use them and I'm gonna answer the most frequently asked questions. Starting with the two most important ones. One, where can I get it? Over at gumroad.com/gallevel and you'll find it right here. Make sure you carefully read the description and check out the previews, so no funny surprises here. I even included a screenshot of exactly the files you will get. Question number two, is it free? And the answer is no, but it's very affordable, $5 minimum, but if you want to tip and give a higher amount, I'll be very thankful. Now, if free products is more of your type of thing, do not worry, because there's over 100 other products on my page and the large majority is completely free, including other 3D animation alerts and stinger transitions and banners and panels and overlays, everything. All right, now I'm going to show you how to add them using Streamelements and then Streamlabs. Then from there, it will work with every broadcasting software. OBS Studio, Streamlab Desktop, Meld Studio, Polypop, even Twitch Studio, if that's still a thing. All right, so from my Streamelements dashboard, I'm going to click top right and make sure that I am logged in with the right account. Right now, it's my Twitch account. Then from there, I'm going to go Streaming Tools and Overlays. Let's create a new overlay. 1080p is right. I'm going to click on Add Widget to start, and we'll go to Alert and alert box. Now you can pick and choose which alert you want to display on this particular overlay. We're gonna click on the cogwheel next to follow. I'm gonna make sure I get rid of the previous animation and I'm gonna click change video. Now on the top right, I'll see upload. So click on that, click in the middle and go find your Twitch follow alert. I made sure to name it Twitch_follow. It'll appear here. You can even preview it and you can click submit. From there, you want to make sure you click text over image because we want the text to overlap. The alert duration is around 7 seconds. And let's try to emulate a follow event. Now, there are two reasons why it appeared like that. One, we need to place the text exactly where we want it. Two, the default alert box size does not match the 16:9 aspect ratio. So I'll go ahead and close this, then go down to position, size, and style, and enter something that is the right ratio. The animations are 1080p, but we can make this 720, which means 1280 by 720. This also means you're getting a better quality than the default one. And now for the text, let's go to layers, settings, follow and text settings, and finally advanced. And from there where it says margin top, we can play around with the numbers until it's placed wherever we want it. I'm gonna keep it at 550, but ultimately you decide where to place it. And you can also use the rest of the tools to customize your text, changing fonts and all that. Once you're done making it look the way you want, we can emulate one more time. And that looks pretty good to me. Now you can go back and basically do the same thing for every alert that you want to modify. Something to watch out for in Streamelements is a couple of those alerts by default will have some variations. Subscriber alert, for example, if we go down, we'll see variation settings. And this is where you can have resub, subscriber gift, and community gifts. So make sure you customize those. Make sure to name your overlay. Get it, SodaStream. And then on top right, you want to save and also copy the overlay URL. Now, back in any streaming software that you use, we're using OBS as an example, but all of them will work. You want to add a browser source or a link or a web page, whatever it's called. Name it appropriately. And where it says URL, you want to paste that URL. You also want to make sure the size is correct. So we had 1280 by 720. Click OK. And if you follow the steps correctly, when you emulate it, it should appear right there. Not bad. And then disappear. And of course, with the alert box, you can place it wherever you want. You can make it bigger, you can make it smaller, you can put it in a corner. Whoa. And also put your own custom sound through the Streamelements page. All right, moving on. Now, if you prefer using Streamlabs for your alerts, let's figure it out. So same thing with Streamlabs, you wanna make sure you are logged in with the right account, which means if you're using it for YouTube, just log in with your YouTube account. On the left here, we will immediately see alert box. Click on that. And this is what the setup looks like. Let's go from top to bottom. So up here, enable, very important. Layout text over image. And that image, whatever you had here, you can get rid of it and click on the upload icon. You can directly drag and drop your files right here or click on it and find it. We'll do follow again, click open. Wait for a couple seconds for it to load. Click on it to select it, then bottom right, select. Alert duration is still 7 seconds. Text delay, we don't necessarily want any. And then the rest of the options are up to you. We can now preview the alert. In order to move it around and maybe play with the shadows and all that, you would have to enable custom CSS. But if you want the text all the way at the bottom, you can always set this to image above text. Then try again. There you go. And if the animation repeats itself, you can just lower the alert duration here. But if you really want to know for the CSS, I just added some padding to alert user message. Make sure you save after messing with the CSS and then preview again. There it is. Just as before, after saving, you want to click to copy widget URL, blah, 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 copy it, then add it to your favorite streaming software. If you're using Streamlabs desktop, all you have to do is add an alert box and it will automatically be in there. But if you're using anything else, paste the URL, click OK. And if you followed everything correctly, when you click test from the website, it should appear right here. So let's say you're gaming on stream and you decide to have your alert around the middle. There you go. That's what it would look like. Again, you can make it bigger, you can make it smaller, you can put it in a corner, maybe something like this. Not bad. For example, getting raided would probably look like this. There you go. Now, in case you're curious about the creative process, I literally had a soda can in front of me and I was like, that could be cool. So I went ahead and designed my own labels. Look at that. I made a custom one for my friend, but I can't use this. Copyright. I then used Blender 3D for the animation and the model here. I had to UV unwrap this so it would fit. Where is it? So you can see the UV map here, making sure everything matches. And then the main color at the back, like the yellow here, is actually determined in the shading tab right there. So I can change it just in case. But also I wanted to separately control the roughness. In other words, how shiny the base color would be compared to the graphics. Then from there, I used a null circle, attached it to the can, and I had to manually go ahead and animate it to fly in, slow down, rotate slightly. I actually wanted to put more rotation and I completely forgot. And I was like, you know what? This project is taking long enough. So it slowly rotates on the x-axis, I believe. And then finally starts rotating and then starts flying away while also rotating. And I rendered that as a WebM file. So there you go. If you want to create it yourself, you just got to learn some Blender, some Photoshop or whatever editing software to create your labels and animate it. Even if you're a complete beginner, there are plenty of tutorials on how to make a soda can in Blender. Oh yeah, and Blender is completely free. So once again, you can find it at gumroad.com/gallevel. Once again, make sure you read the description. Make sure you subscribe and also turn on notifications. Okay, go turn it on and then go to everything. I believe that's what it is. You've set it to everything. So you always get a notification when I post something. I'll see you next time. Go out there. Make me proud. Gallevel out.